Hello, and welcome to episode 5 of our Frequently Asked Questions series. In this week's episode, we'll be looking at everything from potential PoE problems to IP compatibility with other security products. So let's get started with question number 1. Can I connect my IP cameras to my existing security products, such as motion detectors, alarms, and door locks? The simple answer is yes, but only if your IP camera has an alarm in-out port that looks something like this. These ports allow you to directly wire various security products to your IP cameras. The in ports are used by security devices sending information to the camera, such as motion detectors or door sensors. And the out ports are for devices receiving information from the camera, such as floodlights, alarms, and speakers. Now, it should be pointed out that these ports will not power these external security devices. You will instead have to deliver separate power supplies to each device. It is obviously a fiddly and time-consuming process to connect multiple devices to your camera, but with more and more sensors being built into cameras, these external security devices are becoming less necessary and more specialised. Question 2. If standard PoE won't power a high-power PTZ camera, will I have to power it with a 24-volt DC power supply? Yes, you are right that a high-power PTZ will not be powered by standard PoE, but no, you do not have to power it with a 24-volt power supply. A few years back, most of the professional brands, including Axis, Samsung, and Hikvision, started using something called High PoE or PoE Plus with their PTZs. What PoE Plus allows you to do is send more power over the same network cables as standard PoE. This allows you to power PTZs because PTZs consume about 20 watts as an average, and standard PoE can only take a maximum of 15.4 watts, which is obviously not enough. Now compare that to PoE Plus, which has a maximum of 25.5 watts, which should be enough power for almost any modern PTZ camera. It's also important to point out to achieve this PoE Plus output, you will need to buy a PoE Plus capable injector, switch, or MVR. And also, if you have multiple cameras, PTZ or not, connected to a PoE Plus switch or MVR, make sure you know the power budget of said device, as this is the amount of power that can be split across all the ports. So for example, if it was a 30 watt PoE Plus switch, you would be able to connect a 22 watt PTZ camera and possibly a 5 watt standard IP camera, but if you tried to power anything else, like a second PTZ, it wouldn't work. But don't be worried if you don't really understand PoE Plus or you don't want to spend the money on it, because most PTZs will still function perfectly fine using a 24 volt mains power supply. Finally, question number 3. If I have a camera that is 100 meters away or further from my PoE source, can I still get power to it via PoE? The simplest answer to this question is yes, you can go more than 100 meters with PoE, but to do so, you'll have to put in a PoE injector at the end of each 100 meter stretch. But there are several points that we should draw your attention to. First is that even though technically you can send PoE up to 100 meters, practically we would advise not sending it any further than 90 meters if you want to keep the signal strong. The second point is, if you're using a Hikvision I or K MVR to send PoE to your cameras, as of the most recent firmware update, you will now be able to send PoE up to 300 meters with Cat 6 cable. But this will only work for cameras with a power consumption of 8 watts or less, and your bandwidth will be reduced from 100 megabits per second to 10 megabits per second. But this won't massively affect the performance of your cameras. The easiest way to visualize why that is to think of megabits per second as a water pipe. 100 megabits per second pipe is very wide and can send a lot of water very quickly, but only over a short distance. When you drop the megabits per second to 10, the pipe gets smaller and you can't send the same amount of water the same distance as quickly. But you can stretch the pipe further and make the smaller amount of water, or data in our case, travel further. But going back to the start of this answer, in most cases you'll be powering using a switch or injector, and so you will have to place a new injector every 90 meters. This is obviously a lot of hassle, so if you can, we would suggest instead buying Wi-Fi cameras and powering them off the mains near to where you're mounting them. Thank you for watching and subscribing. If you haven't subscribed already, please do by clicking down here. Check out the description below for links to our Facebook, Twitter, and Google Plus accounts. Follow the link here for our webshop, and if you want more videos like this, check out the playlist up here. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.